thank you for joining me today and sharing your story of how using natural medicine has helped you with your gut health experience. I just couldn't be more excited to share your story and your charisma and your ability just to take such a strong and emotionally sound approach to life. Every time I hear you talk about your solutions, it's direct, it's simplified. You are able to stay solution-oriented and positive and really creep out a lot of negativity, man. You're a very unique soul.
Thank you, appreciate it. You've definitely helped cultivate that, though.
Good. Hey, you know, any kind of coach can't really help those who aren't willing to help themselves. The better the quarterback, the better the coach, right? Just like Tom
Absolutely.
Brady, right? You know, Belichick, what's he good for? Tom Brady's the one throwing it, right? First off, tell me a little bit about what life was like when you first got diagnosed and how it affected your day-to-day.
So I had been having issues ever since last year when I got, it was maybe like 2016 actually, when I got food poisoning from eating raw oysters. Mm-hmm. And I had a high dose of antibiotics. And then ever since then, I just didn't feel the same. Mm-hmm. So it slowly got worse and worse, and I don't think I realized it until it really hit me hard in like July of 2017. So end of July, I started having more bowel movements a day. The urgency was just ridiculous. It interfered with me at work. Like I'd be in the middle of something, I'd have to run straight to the bathroom. And then it got to the point where there was blood involved, and that's when it was actually right around the time Irma was hitting Florida and we had to evacuate. There was a ton of stress during that time, and that was like the peak of everything. So when I got back, went to the hospital, they did some tests, had proctitis, and then they referred me to the doctors. Doctors told me that I needed a colonoscopy. Immediately after colonoscopy, doctor brings me to the room. He says, it looks like Crohn's. I bought books. I went to every single website I could find. I read I had like a list of bookmarks of the solutions that that worked for other people. I'm stuck. The doctor had me on some medicines and I was still feeling pretty bad. But I started implementing some of the strategies I saw online, SCD diet, incorporating some supplements to help build my gut back up, and immediately started feeling better. The SCD diet seemed to help me pretty much right away, and I stopped having such frequent urgency, and continued getting better, adding more to my arsenal, and then I felt like I got to a point where I didn't know where to go from there. And right around that time is when I just happened to stumble across some of your videos on YouTube, and led me to you and led me to, you know, put the rest of my puzzle together and figure out, you know, what's good for me.
Yeah, but you know, and that's amazing. And I remember the first time we talked, you really, I'd already tell you put in a lot of work to figure out what you felt was the issue with diet. I mean, you already dove into saying, I'm gonna change my diet. You weren't just second guessing, does diet work? You just said, no, I had already tried these diets, I've already added these supplements, I already built this regimen. So it was really easy for me to come in and we work as a team and kind of critique that and say, how can we really make this strong and effective? And we really blew it out the water. But what were some of the symptoms and lifestyle changes that Crohn's had when you got it? How did it impact you?
Well, I was always pretty active, and like I just remember the one thing that sticks in my mind is my wife and I would wake up most mornings and do yoga, and I couldn't do it, and it was so disappointing. And my wife's like, and you know, I slammed the door, I just went into the bedroom, and I was just in the worst mood ever. Mm-hmm. And she's like, you know, don't be, you'll be okay. But I just knew something was wrong at that point. I was afraid to go to work and not have like a bathroom available because we only had 3 stalls in our new building. Mm-hmm. And there were 100 people in there. And I was just so worried I wouldn't be able to find a stall and something would happen. My mood was, I was just in a bad mood all the time. And I just didn't feel good. Like it was just not a good point in my life. Like I think back now and I don't know if I was depressed, but I was definitely not in a great state of mind. The doctors put me on canasa and sulfasalazine, And I was on those for a bit before starting SED. And they seemed to help a little bit, but it just didn't feel right. Yeah, they just didn't feel right. I mean, my stomach would, even though I wasn't going to the bathroom as often, my stomach just felt weird, like there was butterflies in it all the time. And it was definitely, you know, when I wasn't, if I skipped a dose of the medicine, then I didn't have that feeling. So I know it was attributed to that.
One thing that really helped you out is you took control of this the day you got diagnosed. You went home, researched, and applied. And for anyone out there who's listening, that was huge. You didn't sit there and let the analyzation of what would just happen to you overpower your action steps. You took an immediate action. God knows how bad those results would have got if you would have just sat down and just, you know, dove into Netflix eating potato chips all day and saying, I'm chronically sick, you know, I can't do anything about this. What was really a universal law of healing that you applied is you didn't become paralyzed by what happened and you took immediate action. So anyone out there who's listening, that is huge to be solutions. Spend 90% of your brain power on solutions, only 10% on the problem, the analysis. Once you know there's a problem, spend that time figuring out a solution for it, and that's what you did. And you know, so once we started working together, what were some things that changed for you as far as your health and your empowerment to handle this?
Well, you kind of helped me put together a schedule. Because before that, I mean, I had a little bit here and there, but I was kind of throwing everything at the wall to see what stuck. Mm-hmm. So you really helped me cut out some of the things that, you know, I had just a ridiculous amount of supplements that I was trying, and we cut out some of those supplements. But you really just helped me put together, like, you know, this in the morning, this in the afternoon, this at night will help. And I would give it a try. And if it worked for me, I would stick with it. And if it didn't work for me, I knew right away and I would drop it. But it really helped to get me, like, on a schedule. And as soon as I started doing that, I started noticing more, like, improvements and better results. And once you start feeling better physically, you start feeling better mentally. Mm-hmm. And my mood improved. I had more energy than I can remember having in years. I just felt great, and there was more of a connect, like the mind-body connect. I started meditating more often. Right now, I think I'm on like 45 days straight of meditation, and it's just been so helpful. Mm-hmm. So yeah, like working with you has just been phenomenal. Just because before we started working together, I had the puzzle kind of together. I just needed you to help me fill out the edges.
Yeah.
Nope. Nothing now. I think today I was actually using the journal that you put together. As I've been using that. Today is day number 40 of no drugs, and I've been feeling great. I haven't noticed any change since stopping them. I've been feeling better and better. So it's been great.
Yeah. Amazing. 40 days no drugs, feeling better and better, exercising more than ever, more energy than ever, being healthier than the healthy. And it goes right into, you know, the philosophy of Crohn's Lifestyle, which is this is not just about health or the fear of disease. This is about living the life you want. Crohn's has been a catalyst to open doors of meditation and gut health and how to build a regimen and how to be self-empowered, all that you can use for the rest of your life with all your other goals. So it now has become a gift for you. And, you know, that's an amazing feat that I'm so happy to share. I'm so happy to see you do. So, Nick, thank you so much for your time, and thank you for sharing with other people. Let me ask you, if there's one thing you can say to other people out there who are struggling, maybe they just got diagnosed, maybe they've been going through some things like you have with just got diagnosed Crohn's disease, what would you recommend or say to others out there?
You can heal. It's in there, and you have to really find the mind-body connection, really strive to find what works for you. What works for one person doesn't always work for another person. So give it a try. I mean, like I said, I was throwing stuff against the wall to see what stuck, and it's not a really long-term solution, but it definitely helped me figure out what was working for me in the short term. And it led me to you, because I was just do your research, find out what's worked for other people, and you'll be surprised to what you find. I mean, at this point in my life, since the diagnosis, I've kind of realized that you know, life is really worth living, and there's goals to be had, And obviously everyone's goals are different, but once you get sick, you kind of realize, you know, once you start to feel a little bit better, you're like, I'm going to take advantage of this. So it's there for you, and you can heal.
You can take something that's really hard and can be the worst thing that ever happened to you, and that worst thing can grow and flourish into the best thing that ever happened to you. Today, I help people reverse their symptoms from Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis.